Hi everyone, welcome back. Hope you all are doing well. Some weekend moments sharing in this video where you get to see a glimpse of behind the camera or just showing how my vlog life is like. Preparing jalebi and some shopping. Hope you would like it. Keep watching. We get really crispy jalebis from a shop that's not very near to where we stay. It's from Salman Sweets. They have really crispy and juicy jalebis. So try the similar type. Anyway, Diwali is coming up, so you could try it for that special day. Diwali wishes in advance for whoever celebrating. In a blender, add 1 cup all-purpose flour or maida. Then goes 2 tablespoon corn flour, 4 tablespoon curd, 4 teaspoon ghee, 1/2 cup water. Now water is as per the consistency. You may have to add 2 tablespoons more for the correct consistency. Blend well. Add to a mixing bowl. Add around 1/4 teaspoon or a pinch of baking soda. You may add color. I added 1/4 teaspoon turmeric powder. There isn't any change in the taste if adding turmeric powder. Give a mix and let the batter rest for 15 minutes. Now for the sugar syrup, you need 2 cups sugar and 1 cup water. Add few cardamom pods. Again, a pinch of turmeric, around 1/4 teaspoon. Now this is optional, you may even add saffron. Here I forgot to add a tablespoon of lemon juice, which helps in getting rid of the crystallization of sugar. So do add that. You need to get 1 string consistency and then take it off. Using a fry pan for frying the jalebis. So this is the consistency you will need for the batter. If you feel the batter is loose, you may add more flour and adjust accordingly. It shouldn't be very thick nor very loose. Now shaping the jalebis is something I find really challenging. You need to get used to this job to get it perfect. You need to keep on low flame or else it can burn quickly. It becomes ready in a minute or two. Add the fried jalebis to the warm syrup. Let it be dipped in the syrup for 15 to 20 seconds. Then you can serve on the plate. Now, I'm not sure of the channel name. When I was browsing YouTube just like that, I got to see a thumbnail where the jalebis were made with perfection. And my eyes was on the views of that video. It was 10 million views. I don't remember the channel name, nor have I seen that video. I just saw the thumbnail and tried. The credit is completely to that video to give an idea on how to get that round perfect shape. So that's the perfect one and this is the imperfect one. Anyways, the taste is same. Boys were busy in their world as it's weekend. Thank you. Next day morning, we plan to have breakfast from McDonald's just to make kids happy. Arman is there just to get the toy from Happy Meal, and Rehan loves the feel of having breakfast from such places.
And the other two is coffee.
The two
For dinner that day, I was preparing noodles. Now, I'm not showing the complete recipe here. It's the same as the mushroom noodles I had prepared earlier, except that I skipped the mushrooms as I didn't have it at home. Thought of showing you a glimpse of how I shoot my videos. Nowadays, I use camera, and in between, I take from my iPhone as well. But most of the time, it's camera. Now, this is how it's placed. The camera angles depends on my mood. And that's my husband who came back from club. But Rehan stood back. I don't take videos from two cameras, or both iPhone and camera. It'll be difficult while I edit. So this is where I place my phone while opening the fridge. If I'm taking on a camera, I won't need this, but when taking on a phone, I will need the chair to place the tripod. It's not an easy task while cooking because I need to keep changing the camera. Initially, it was really hard, but now it's a part of my lifestyle and I enjoy videography. This is for Rehan. Before calling everyone for food, I need to set the camera. So that becomes the shot for a vlog, and this is behind the camera. I change position 2-3 times, and again it depends. Finally, I keep the camera away and enjoy my meal. Later, we went to pick Rehan from club. Craving for kulfi, but got only caramel ice cream. Wasn't a big fan. And my husband has his unique style to try food. That's vanilla ice cream. To that, he added pieces of jalebi. Going to the gym depends on how my day goes. If I'm busy in the morning, I go evening time. This was a Saturday and I had planned to go shopping at IKEA with my dear friend Naja. So went gym in the morning. Now, many of you had asked me how much weight I lost by going gym. I'm a total foodie who goes gym just to maintain the weight. If I want to lose weight, I control the food intake, which is not in my routine always. If I feel I gained a lot of weight, I go on a portion control, which helps in losing weight. I had just one banana before gym, and after getting back, didn't feel like having any meal, so I just had a smoothie. That's one banana, few frozen strawberries, few cashews, a teaspoon of chia seeds, and milk. So that's all I had. Off we go to IKEA. Naja was on the way and I reached IKEA already. I was terribly feeling hungry. Naja was still on the way. She had lunch from home, so asked me to carry on. So I went up straight to the restaurant to have whatever available. The most famous one at IKEA is the Swedish meatballs with mashed potatoes. And there she comes. She is a mother of 3 kids. Her elder kids are twins, a boy and a girl. The younger one is just 1.5 years old, so he is with us. even if I don't have anything to shop at IKEA. It's lovely to see the arrangements there. After 2 hours of roaming around and shopping bits and pieces, we had a meal. I was almost full from the meatballs, but it's always good to have a chat over a meal. So we shared a meal and I had a coffee as well. I don't know why, but I end up buying something from IKEA. That's the reason my husband ignores me when I say I want to go to IKEA. And that ends today's vlog. Hope you enjoyed. If so, do give a thumbs up and don't forget to hit the subscribe button. See you with another video. Until then, take care. Bye-bye.